Hey there, this is your orchestration tutor Thomas Goss, 6 Sundays into 2013, with a video tip about the tenor tuba and its use in the Planets by Gustav Holst. But let's take a quick look at what is and what isn't a tenor tuba. First, you have to understand the tuba family as a whole. There are 5 members, starting at the bottom with the double C and double B flat tubas. These used to be specialty instruments, but they've now become standard in most top-level orchestras. Then there are the F and E flat tubas, pitched a little higher, but still capable of getting a lot of those rock-bottom fundamentals. These used to be the standard, but have been a bit sidelined by their big brothers. However, they're easier to play and more agile in technique. Then we have the tenor tuba, pitched in 9-foot B-flat. Even though our star instrument for this week can play some of the very low pedal tones if needed, its real strength is in the vocal tenor range, from the middle of the bass staff up to a few ledger lines over it. It's a very secure, easy-to-tune instrument, and blends great for certain emphatic types of doubling. Now for what a tenor tuba is not. It's not a baritone horn, which is a type of bugle with pistons perfected by Adolf Sachs. The difference is in the bore, which has a more cylindrical start than the tenor tuba's nearly constant cone. The baritone is mostly a band instrument, though there are one or two great orchestral cameos. A tenor tuba is also not a Wagner tuba, one of those huge hybrid horns that you sometimes hear in movie soundtracks. But it's almost a euphonium. In fact, the difference between a true tenor tuba, like the kind you hear in Strauss, and the euphonium seems to be largely whether the instrument uses valves or pistons, along with a couple of other minor details in body shape. Nowadays, the euphonium is used most commonly when the score asks for tenor tuba. It's a great instrument for playing heavy octaves with the lower brass, blending with other sections, and taking part in chorales. But what I really want to share with you today is its use by Holst in the Planets, especially in the movement Mars. Consider that the movement starts out as a study in highly experimental, imaginatively textured scoring. Col legno in strings, doubled by harps, and timpani with wood sticks, under which a tam-tam rolls. From there on, it's a study in crescendo, with ominous gestures slowly evolving chordally. Into sections working together with massed textures like an army. But all through 57 bars of this intense, aggressive opening, there isn't a single solo anywhere. The sections themselves stand out from time to time, or work collectively to get the point across, all the way up to the place where the music breaks, and the tenor tuba takes the first solo in the movement. I find this to be incredibly ingenious. First, look at where it's pitched, in the highest octave of the tenor tuba. It guarantees that the sound will be very throaty, with a cutoff of some of the higher frequencies that the listener might expect from trombones or trumpets in the same range. Second, like many other moments in this suite, Holst gets the maximum amount of effect for the smallest amount of ideas. This tendency is taken to its logical extreme as the tenor tuba returns a few bars later to play counterpoint to the muted trumpets, and slowly increases its leaps up to concert A-flat, one step below its highest note. Biggest stroke of genius is simply in the placement of the solo and its context. The Planets was composed during World War I, when brutality and death had accelerated to unimaginable levels. In composing Mars, Holst was definitely commenting on the horrors and stupidities of war. Even moments that seem heroic are dragged down into the mud and blood and grit of the battlefield. After that huge build, the first instrument allowed to speak its mind individually doesn't stir us like a trumpet solo, or charm us like a horn solo. Rather, it fills us with dread, with the braying of a simple-minded call to arms, with the trumpets jumping on the statement like warhawks whipping up the troops. Holst had a very developed social conscience, and was suspicious of blind patriotism and nationalism, especially as he saw the war erasing whole populations of the common man with whom he identified. Though The Planets was written with a musical rather than social agenda, it's the height of craft and ingenuity to use exactly the right instrument in the right place to immediately bring home what most people were thinking at the time. War, as it was being waged, was costing us our humanity. Since last week's video tip, I've been posting daily tips about scoring for tuba. Join the Orchestration Online group on Facebook to read them, or just click the links below. I'm also posting them on Twitter if you'd like some daily advice and perspective on the craft of orchestration. Don't miss next week's tip, all about sol tosto bowing for the string section, and how composers often get it wrong without even realizing it. Hope to see you then.